All right, if you were on a Mac, go ahead and open up your browser. I don't mind Google Chrome. Google Chrome actually has been working pretty well lately. And go ahead and type in mycsunsoftware.csun.edu into your browser and hit enter. This will bring you to the login page. We need to enter your CSUN credentials. This is your typical CSUN username password that you would use for the portal. Go ahead and click log on, and it should bring you to this window, especially if this is your first time installing the software. So go ahead and click install to get the download started. And while we're doing that, go ahead and open up your system preferences icon. Go up to security and privacy at the very top here. And what we need to do is, because this is a program, it's not offered in the App Store, we have to go in to our computer. What I mean by that is to enter your password if you have one, and to see if this option where it says allow apps downloaded from under the general tab is set to anywhere. Just temporarily, you can move it back afterwards. It's what we need to do to make sure that the software will install correctly. So then make sure it's set to anywhere, then we can go ahead and close our panel. And then once this is done downloading, we can go ahead and install the software. Okay, so the software has just finished downloading, so I'm going to go ahead and open it up. It's this DMG file called Citrix Online Plugin. Then we're going to want to, once this window opens here, double-click Install Citrix Online Plugin. And then follow all the prompts, clicking Continue, Continue, Agree. Give the plugin a couple of seconds to find your hard drive. It usually takes me about a minute for it to find mine. Okay, so I'm going to select my hard drive, click continue, then install, then enter your password if prompted. It should only take a couple of seconds before it finishes. Go ahead and click close. Looks like I opened up a second instance. If you did that, click close, shut that window down. Go ahead and quit your browser because you probably will need to be reset. I'm just going to eject this disk that we used to install. And then I'm going to reopen the browser. Now, one more time, we're going to enter the mycsunsoftware.csun.edu URL. By now, it should be saved in your history. We're going to enter our credentials for CSUN one more time. And now we should be allowed inside to the VSL. But if not, just click skip to log on because we have indeed installed it. And this is what you should come to once everything has been done and the install has completed. You should see a series of folders. Now what you see is going to differ than what I see because of what you're enrolled in versus the fact what I teach. It's going to make everyone's view different. But you should see ArcGIS 10.3. That's the only thing that really matters for this assignment.